All right, boy, we got a lot of stuff going on tonight. You've been seeing all these logistical things going on. Well, it's worth your time, and we're only a minute late right now. Before you know it, the world will be full of lovely music, and we'll all be smiling because of it. There's lots going on tonight. The Missoula Community Chorus is here with us this evening. Say hi to them, will you?
Hi!
We've got them stuck right in the middle of the band. We're going to make musicians out of them after all. Here's the Star Spangled Banner. Hey, we've got some birthdays going on. Irvin Rentz is going to be 94. Where are you, Irvin? Right here. Look at that fella. And Carol Williams' birthday is coming up. I'm not going to talk about Carol's age, okay? Hey, please let us help. Hang on, hold on. You're right there. She's front and center. You don't want to share that private information, do you? You do what? Hey, Carol, please tell me. 2 years from 90. 2 years from 90. That means you're 92? Is that what that means, Carol? Thank you. Jenny Scrimseth up in front of the choir. Say hi, Jenny. Of course, you don't need a road map to know that was Sing, Sing, Sing. And my buddy and my next door neighbor, Rich Brinkman, on drum set right here. Look it, watch out. We put him up front. I'm a little afraid what's going to happen. I'm going to invite a couple of my horn player buddies down here. We're going to do Ain't Misbehaving. Bill Happy on clarinet, Ross Tate on trumpet.
Good evening. Hi, I'm Ron Wilcott. I'm the artistic director and conductor of the Missoula Community Chorus. We're very, very pleased to be here tonight to sing for you. Jenny Scripseth is our associate conductor, and our wonderful accompanist is Alice Williams. Let's give her a big round of applause. These last two tunes and the two more that you're going to hear, the next two you're going to hear, were in our spring concert. This one is by Z. Randall Stroop, and it's called Omnia Soul.
Thank you.
And our last tune with the city band tonight is Wilhowsky's Battle Hymn of the Republic. My wife is going to tell me I shouldn't tell this story, so I'm not going to tell this story, except... No, I won't tell this story. So here we go. I'll keep you in... Okay, I got to tell the story now. Not that I'm anybody special, but I was the first person to conduct the Mormon Tabernacle Choir in concert, non-staff person to conduct them in concert. Just had to do with being at the right place at the wrong time and of having a pushy choir mom who didn't know that they didn't ever have a choir, have guest conductors. So I got to sing this, to conduct the Mormon Tabernacle Choir, 320 singers, plus I matched their 320 singers with 320 singers from St. George, Utah, where I was teaching at the college in the time. So we had 640 people singing this piece. It was an amazing experience. This is an amazing experience as well. So enjoy Wilhowsky's Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Thank you.
I know. We talked about programming. Like, how do we follow up that? It'll be a varied program. And we'll sure that as the band scrunches back in, our choir is moving out. The wrecking crew is in taking care of this wonderful piano. Compliments of Morgan Roth Music. Yeah, thank you to Morgan Roth. And the poobah in charge of the move right there. You see him in that ugly looking Hawaiian shirt. That's Gary Bowman. That's the guy who owns the store. That'll be Gary Bowman's music. That's what I say. Careful there, boys. Well, we've got plenty of great music for you to enjoy. We've got a clarinet concertino coming up. We've got some great band music that we found in Butte, America. We've got a vocal solo. I took one of those singers from the choir, and I've got him singing a solo with us. So right now, we're going to send our folks out, and we'd appreciate whatever kind of donation you'd like to give to the cause. And we're going to perform for you this wonderful gallop that I stole from the Boston, Montana band. It probably hadn't been played in 100 years. Here is a steeplechase. Thank you. Well, we're in for a treat here this evening. Megan Snow has developed into a great little clarinetist. It's been fun to have her in the band for so many years, and I always put the word out. Please, if you're interested in playing a solo with the band, especially somebody from within the band, it even makes it, warmer. She plays like crazy, and this is a wonderful, serious clarinet work, the Von Weber Concertino for Clarinet. You will love it and be amazed by her playing. Please say hi to Megan.
Thank you.
my gosh, huh? Megan's went to high school, Big Sky, and goes to school, University of Montana, and because of her being here, she keeps inviting her friends here. And we've got a lot of college punks in the band this year because of Megan. Hey, you college punks, wave high. They save our bacon, I tell you that, man. And I mean punks in a very nice way. You know that, punks, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I can get by with this joke because I play one as well. But if the terminology from the sublime to the ridiculous can be any better put, get ready. Because we went from the beautiful Von Weber clarinet concertino the trombones playing a smear. And if Fred Looney, you're out there somewhere, suck it up. The trombone is the only of God's instruments that can do this outlandish, wonderful pyrotechnics. You will be astounded. Do we have enough trombones tonight?
Yes. No.
6, 8, 10. I don't know. I got to a dozen and lost count. Here is Henry Fillmore's Sally Trombone.
Thank
Huh? But you want to play trombone, though, don't you, huh? Yeah? Yeah? Henry Fillmore wanted to play the trombone so bad that he hid in his father's coat closet and practiced his trombone because they wouldn't let him play it. At 14, he ran away from home. The urge was so overcoming to play the trombone. Obviously a sick person, and we all share some of that sickness.
Yeah.
Here's a characteristic tune, 100 years old, of how we, as a white dominant culture, saw Native American music at that time. Probably hadn't been played in 100 years since Butte, America. Enjoy. If you want to hear real Native American music, like just go up to Arlene during powwow days. Oh my gosh. You know, it was a stab by a guy 100 years ago to give an idea of what we thought was going on with Native American music. We've only got to travel a mile or two or to your next door neighbor to find real Native American music. Hey, I found this singer, and we've got this cool little old song called Molly on a Trolley. And it probably had, again, probably hadn't been played in 100 years. And it is so cute. Will you please welcome to the bandstand Hank Jennings and Molly Alatrali.
Like a dolly to me.
Thank you, Ned. Perfect song. Thanks, Ron, for finding the perfect singer for that song for us. What fun. And did you see they actually found a way to rhyme Kalamazoo? It was a hit in England. Kalamazoo was a long trolley ride from London, I'll guarantee you that. And we're going to end up our program this evening with a great tune from 1862. It was a musical called The Great Parisian Success, and it's a two-step, which is a wonderful way for us to walk out of here this evening, remember the great times we had, and we'll see you next week. Watch out, because next week is Gary Herbig's in town. So watch out. Watch out. He's bringing friends with him, and we're taking no prisoners. Here, see you in Paris. Evening. Thanks, Jay, for the great sound. Ron, good to have you here. You can catch us on MCAT TV or stream it on your fancy computer. We'll see you next week.